All right, so this is the last mission in Hornet's campaign 1989, and it's going to be an offensive counter-air, so we're going to go in and blow up a bunch of the airfield over here that the Russians just took from the Georgians. This is also the first time I'm recording in VR, and we'll see how it goes. Got a little bit too high there. T-lambs all being launched off. I'm supposed to hover or circle around here for 5 minutes. And that'll allow the T-lambs to get in and do their work on the enemy. SA-6s, SA-8s, all those good things that are in the AO. Loaded down with four Mark 84s because apparently helo hunting on the ground is requiring some of our biggest bombs, so that's cool. Man, I forgot the phone support step. I forgot to put my custom skin on for the Crusaders, so. Oh well. Climb all the way up to 20,000 feet and then head in from there. Now, ideally, I would have gone out inside of 10 miles and then climbed, came back in, and just gotten to the port overhead for holding, but I'm lazy. And there's nobody else flying that I'm going to run into, so we're good. I wish there was a better way to do this than these stupid labels. I might go back to the dot mod instead of using these default dots. Because it is just difficult to do anything in VR to see anything, but these dots are a little bit much. I will say that my spatial awareness from using this headset has gone through the roof. Like, my ability to dogfight and track a target is just immensely better with the VR headsets over track IR. I'm very happy with that, but the resolution is a bit rough. If we can get this with sharper resolution, and if you could actually spot one of the NAM in DCS, like if they can fix VR spotting, I don't think I would ever go back. Even my traps on the carrier have gotten better, because you just judge depth perception and closure rates. Just spatial awareness is way better. Also tried VR in X-Plane 11, and that's pretty freaking cool too. Just being in some of those bigger cockpits. Flight deck on the Zippo 737 is pretty neat. Man, it's a fun aircraft to fly if you like two-liners. And it's free. Well, came with the game at least. Then just bought. Alright, looks like we got a couple friendly F-14s in the air and coming back. That's probably who some of those contrails are. Self-escorts, and I have no idea why you would think self-escorts would be a good idea for this mission. The last mission that we're going to do, that means that we're going to have plenty of maintenance days after we leave, put the planes up, and we've got apparently a division of F-14s up on cap over the ship. It's like, come on, get your head in the game. Radar contact at 11 o'clock in 55 miles. Matches with that 29. You guys have AIM 54s, come help. Probably wouldn't even have to leave your cap orbit. So I may not have the option of just going directly in and drop these marking fours. I may have to go in and engage some of the other aircraft because we're at 40 miles. This is 6, we're pretty far out. I think we're good. Alright, there's bandits right over the airfield. Going directly to target. I'm not going to take this little mini dog leg. So we're 38 from target and 37-ish from wherever this target is. And another one at 65 miles. Probably closer to 70. section. I got rid of my bag and I'm set up to be able to get rid of my bombs if I have to. Maybe the 29s are dealing with the seed strike.
Looks like most of the SA-6s, well,
half the SA-6s are down. Alright, got that section at 40 miles. Oh, there's the seed strike going on. And I can see the target. Alright, we're going to try to race these SUs to the target. Probably not a good idea.
Flight.
Alright, buddy, get some. Box one. Box two. Merged.
I forgot to turn on my helmet mounted display.
God damn it. That's not good. not successful. So why did we do this without a escort again? Seems pretty dumb to me.